In this step-by-step tutorial, we're demonstrating the simple and easy setup process for the WisePad 3 card reader. Keep watching to learn how to set up your card reader and how to accept tap and chip payments. Hey everyone, it's Allie with Shopify. Before we get started on the WisePad 3 setup, there's a few important setup requirements we need to go over first. For full details on eligibility and card reader setup requirements, see the links in the description. First, this video discusses the WisePad 3 card reader. To follow along, make sure that your card reader matches what you see here. Next, make sure that you're using a compatible iPad or iPhone running on the software versions linked below. You also need to confirm that both your device and Shopify POS app have Bluetooth enabled. Open the Settings app on your device and tap Bluetooth. Be sure the Bluetooth button is toggled on. Then scroll to the POS app and toggle on the Bluetooth button here too. Then enable location settings for your POS. Don't worry if you don't see the location settings right now. You'll be asked to enable locations when you connect the card reader later. Next, you need to set up Shopify Payments as your payment provider with test mode disabled. For a full walkthrough on how to set up Shopify Payments, see the links in the description. After this is done, we need to enable Shopify Payments in the POS app. From your POS app, tap the menu icon, then tap Settings. On the new page, tap Payment Settings, then Credit Debit. Make sure the button for Accept Credit Cards at Checkout is toggled on. Now you're ready to set up your reader. Tap back to go to the settings page. You can connect your reader in a few different ways. The first is to tap Connected in the bottom right and tap Set Up Hardware. The second is to scroll to the hardware section on the settings screen and tap Set Up Hardware. Either method brings you to the same screen, select hardware type. From the list of hardware, tap Card Reader, and then tap WisePad 3. Follow the on-screen prompts and press the power button on the front of the reader. This action enables Bluetooth pairing mode. When the reader is discovered by your device, the name of the reader appears with a device number. Confirm that the correct reader is being paired by checking that the last four digits of the serial number on the back of the reader match what is showing on the POS app. After you confirm that the numbers match, tap Connect Card Reader. The device will take a few seconds to pair. You might also see a prompt to update the reader's software. Tap Continue if you see the screen so the software updates in the background. Otherwise, tap Finish Setup. Next, the Shopify POS app shows you an overview of the card reader. Tap Next or Skip to move through the screens. Then tap Connected to see the connectivity status of your reader. Here, you see the WisePad reader we just connected. Tap on your WisePad to see more details like the battery percentage, serial number, and where to get help. After the card reader is paired, it stays connected unless one of the following scenarios take place. 1. You close the Shopify POS app, but the card reader should automatically connect once you open the Shopify POS app again. 2. You select Connect Card Reader even though the WisePad is already connected. This triggers the connection process to start over. Or 3. You select Forget Card Reader. If any of these scenarios take place, follow the steps outlined in this video to connect your card reader again. Now that your card reader is connected, it's time to take a payment. For full details on how to customize your cart, like adding products, customers, and discounts, see the links in the description for a full walkthrough. Now, let's look at an example of accepting payment. Here we have an order with a t-shirt in the cart and the customer's information already added. Tap Checkout. If the WisePad 3 terminal is connected and ready, the tap or insert card option becomes available on the reader. To use the chip, instruct your customer to insert their card. A screen prompting them to enter their PIN appears. This example is with a credit card, but if the customer is using a debit card, the options will be slightly different. When the transaction is approved, the customer can remove their card. If the customer chooses to tap their card, they need to hold their card against the face of the WisePad until it beeps. The transaction will then be authorized and approved. Tap payments can have purchase limits depending on the payment type and country. If your customer is making a large purchase or they've exceeded their tap limit, have them insert their card and use their PIN instead. After the transaction is approved, choose whether to provide a receipt and the customer's preferred delivery method. Now you know how to set up your WisePad 3 and how to accept payments. For more videos on Shopify POS card readers, subscribe now. And for more information, visit help.shopify.com.